Hugh, turning now to the very latest in the red tide track just released tonight. That map here from FWC showing the toxic bloom now hovering around Manatee and Sarasota counties, but inching closer to Pinellas beaches tonight, Wendy.
That's right, Paul. And take a look at this right here. Some beachgoers are now trying to get more funding for red tide research. Our Jake Peterson shows us that the protests they're now planning.
For more than a week now, beachgoers have been coming to Anna Maria Island and seeing dead fish all over the place. Now a group is joining together to show unity.
The extent of it this year is something that cannot be ignored any longer.
Cortez business owner Elizabeth Shore grew up here.
Red tide is a natural occurrence. It comes and it goes. Everyone's used to it. It stays around for a week or two. It moves out. This is something totally different.
She says this year's red tide is lasting longer and killing more fish than ever before.
It's just affecting everybody. People are upset.
And that's why they are organizing the Hands Along the Water event for Sunday. Protesters believe part of the problem is man-made. They say the algae-filled water releases from Lake Okeechobee are feeding the red tide, making it stronger.
It's made this explosive situation.
These are different populations, different species.
Moat marine scientists say it's too early to tell if the Lake Okeechobee waters are affecting the red tide on our coast.
This is a question that we just don't have the answer to right now. That takes a lot of monitoring that is not currently happening.
Shore and her group say they hope lawmakers see their message of unity on Sunday and find more red tide solutions. There are 7 locations where people will be protesting. We have a listing of those locations at abcactionnews.com. Reporting on Anna Maria Island, Jake Peterson, ABC Action News.